MSMotosuit Motocross TV.
Good morning, motocross fans. You are watching the MSMotosuit Motocross TV, and we'll bring you to San Jose, Dinagat for the fourth round of the MSMotosuit Motocross series. In this episode, we'll show you the first heat for the 85cc class, local enduro class, first heat for the intermediate open class, and the first heat for the executive A class. So for the next 30 minutes, witness motocross racing. I'm your host, Pep Burubi of Quick Life Racing. Check this out.
Here's a recap of the third leg of the MSMotosuit Motocross Series, dubbed as the first Toledo City Motocross Challenge held last month. Over hundreds of riders from Visayas and Mindanao joined the first Toledo Motocross Challenge. A total of 15 categories were competed by top riders. In the Pro Open Class and Expert category, it's a back-to-back champion for Cebu's Pride and international rider John John Adlawan, who was the overall champion in the said categories, outclassing other Cebu's top riders Jovenel Abiliar and John Flores. First runner-up in the Expert and Pro Open Class goes to Jovenel Abiliar, while John Flores grabbed the third position in both Pro Open and Expert class. However, John Flores regained his composure in the Intermediate Open, grabbing the overall winner in the said category. Ranked second was Donkey Sanchez, while JP Cuesta ranked third. In the Novice Open production, Jade Luna outsmarted his rival from Iloilo City, Dexter Bacabaco placed second, while Donkey Sanchez placed third. Again, it's a back-to-back round for Jade Luna in the Beginners Open production, after dominating fellow rider Resty de la Calzada and Denmark Supatan. Jade Luna is the overall winner in the Open Enduro class, outsmarting Donkey Sanchez and JP Cuesta. However, Donkey Sanchez retaliated in the local Enduro, his favorite category, by grabbing the podium and bested other riders Nelson Bacolfo and Alex Abalo. In the executive division, Rosel Gumob was the overall champion in two executive categories, namely Executive A and Executive B, while fellow executive riders James Duroy and Nelson Sikat grabbed the second and third position, respectively. Nandik Pepito was the champion in the Executive C, followed by Jonathan Cuyos and Rudy Nadella, who both grabbed the second and third, respectively. For MSMotosuit Motocross TV, I'm Ramila Yuman. Since 1989, MSMotosuit seat cover is a byword among motocross enthusiasts. The original manufacturer in the country today of quality motosuit seat cover. As the years gone by, MSMotosuit seat covers has retained its quality and its durability. MSMotosuit seat cover. It is safe for motorcycle lovers because of its grip seat that can hold a rider whether in a motocross competition or in an ordinary ride. MSMotosuit seat covers is also designed in all kinds of weather condition. MSMotosuit seat covers, the design for your bike, suit for your life.
MSMotosuit, suit for your life, design for your bike.
Okay, welcome back, and those were the official winners for the third round of the MSMotosuit Motocross Series, which was done in Toledo City, Cebu. And this is now the fourth round of the series for the 2014 MSMotocross. And we bring you to the Dinagat Island for the fourth round. And this is now the first heat for the 85cc class. The gate is dropped. Six riders are here right now: BJ Pepito, Leonardo Philip, Ninyo Manyakap, Lloyd Abrinica, Madmad Bandigan, and Medina are here to compete for the pride and glory of motocross racing for the 2014 series on who will be the 2014 Rider of the Year in this category. Six riders are battling for the pride and glory for that specific position in this class. BJ Pepito and Philip Leonardo are battling for first position or first place position in this series. These guys have been battling that for the fourth round, and in this race right now, it's anybody's game because this is the first ever 3.5 kilometer racetrack, a racetrack which is carved by the side of the very huge mountain here in San Jose Dinagat for motocross racing. So these are the guys who will be battling for the pride and glory on who will be this year's 2014 Rider of the Year for the mini class. And right now, leading the pack is number 808, Philip Leonardo, who comes from Osami City, and being challenged by BJ Pepito, who comes from Dan Batayan, Cebu. So it's a very dusty racetrack, and this is the Glen Helen of racetracks in the Philippines right now. This is motocross racing. So whoever wins this race right now will battle for the second heat, because this is just the first race of the fourth round of this series. So it's anybody's game yet for today. So the battle is between Philip Leonardo and BJ Pepito for the fourth round of this series. So next, we will bring you the local Enduro class, and it's going to be one false move by this rider because it's a very dusty racetrack here in Dinagat Motocross. So it's a one false move and you're gone. So that was BJ Pepito who took the position away from Ninyo Manyakap, because Philip Leonardo is way ahead from the other guys. So I think a comment from one of the cameramans shot a video of this. Joel, what can you say about the racetrack?
Siguro sa lahat ng racetrack na napuntahan ko, ito yung pinakamahirap, pero napakaganda talaga. Grabe ang ganda.
Yes, it's maganda grabe dahil it's the first 3.5 kilometer and the checkered flag is up. The official winners for the first heat, Philip Leonardo got first, Ninyo Manyakap second, Lloyd Abrinica third, fourth went to BJ Pepito, and fifth, Madmad Bandigan. Local Enduro after this.
Okay.
How do you feel na? You were the one taking the lead.
Happy.
Happy. And what is your secret to be winning this race?
Inner.
Did you feel already that you will be taking the lead? Congratulations, you're the man!
Okay, that was an interview with the winner of the 85cc class, Philip Leonardo, and this is now the first heat for the local Enduro class. Most of these guys are locals because they come from Dinagat Island and Surigao, and only Alex Abalo, who comes from Cebu City, who is a leader in point standing for this class, the local Enduro class, and he is, you know, dominating this class because Alex is talagang serioso when it comes to motocross racing. We had an interview with Alex, and he said he practiced almost 3 times a week with his KMX motorcycle to defend or to get the title for the Novice Local Enduro Championship in the 2014 MS MotoSuit Motocross. So right now he is showing off with the other guys na talagang he is the rider to beat. The riders who are here right now, and as you can see in the air camera we have provided by Benji Ecleo, we can see the whole racetrack, the 3.5 kilometer racetrack, the first ever in Mindanao, a motocross racetrack this big that will cater all categories and all kinds of motorcycles here in this racetrack. So the riders for this class are Alex Abalo, Bintot Domo, Zachary Vales, Viberson Anduhisa, AR Acosto, Rexa Salsado, and Careboy John Jones. Careboy Jones Aldon. I'm sorry, that's the name. And these are the guys who are battling for the 125 Enduro. So this is just the first heat for this class, and they'll still be competing with each other for the second heat here in the Extreme Motocross Racetrack in San Jose, Dinagat. White flag is up for the 125 local enduro class for Alex Abalo, who is dominating this class, and this category is only scheduled for 4 laps because of the lap time, the number of minutes these guys will take in 1 lap. So the race is a 4-lap schedule. If positions will not change, checkered flag is up, and the official winners for the first heat, Bintot Domo for the first position, Alex Abalo second, Zachary Vales third, Viberson Alduhesa fourth, and fifth goes to AR Cajusto. After this, the intermediate open class category after this.
Dinagat Island is the home of the Philippine Benevolent Missionaries Incorporated, PBMA, founded by the Ecleo clan. MS MotoSuit production team had a chance to take a glance of its wonderful and fascinating views of the island on top of the mountain in San Jose, Dinagat, where the castle is located. Dinagat Island is so blessed with wonders after wonders of nature. Some of its members describe the island as the promised land. One of the newest provinces in the Philippines, Dinagat used to be part of Surigao del Norte until in 2012, the Supreme Court ruled its finality as a new province. This unique and elegant mansion is the home of Governor Glenda Ecleo, the wife of their Divine Master Robin Ecleo Sr. The mansion is called the Islander's Castle.
Ang Dinagat is an island. Unya, an island composed of so many islets. That's why we called it Islander's Castle. Kasi naitayo siya dito mismo sa isla sa Dinagat. Oh, so mas asotid siya tawagon na mo Islander's Castle. Pero sa luyo ni ana nga pagtawag na mo Islander's Castle, daghan pa kayo na sa istorya nga atong pag-isigutan. Kini nga lugar nga Pinoyanan sa atong giila nga among giila nga inahan sa kapunungan. 90s, di lang ko makasiguro o unsa gyud ang exact year nga gisugdan siya. Hing ipuyaan ni sa pagsugod, 2007.
It can't be denied that Dinagat Island became controversial few years back. But Benji Ecleo is optimistic that in due time the province will be transformed into the extreme sports capital of the Philippines. This is one of the reasons Benji Ecleo has organized over 20 motocross competitions this year, and the biggest motocross challenge was recently held last June 18 attracting hundreds of top riders from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao in this 3.5-kilometer racetrack.
Wala ma-expose yung area ko, yung area namin dito sa Dinagat Islands.
So what can people basically expect sa atong province?
Wow, they can expect plenty. People here are really warming, no? Talagang tinatanggap nila yung mga visitors. And then may mga beaches din kami. Madami. Mga may bat sanctuary kami. You can also dive on our reefs. No, meron kami mga sanctuary sa dagat din also. Yeah. Ano, sports. Kung musclehead ka, you can train here really well. I invite you all to come visit our province, Dinagat Islands, here in San Jose. And to the whole island, though, if you want ecotourism, you can visit us, you can contact us, or you can go to our website, dinagatislands.com.ph, I think.
For MS MotoSuit Motocross TV, I'm Ramila Yuman.
Okay, this is now the first heat for the intermediate class. We only have four riders who made it here in the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series. Wilson Pamorca from Guimaras, Iloilo. We have Duydoy Bandigan, Dinagat Racing Team from Mati, Davao. Janjan Flores from Cebu City, and the rider before that was Scott Raymon from Lucky FS Motor Parts, Dumaguete City. So this is the first heat for the intermediate class, which is scheduled for 5 laps here in the 3.5-kilometer motocross racetrack in San Jose, Dinagat, for the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series. And the gate is dropped. Four riders will be battling for first place position in the first corner. Who will get the whole shot is rider from Cebu, Janjan Flores, Scott Raymon, Wilson Pamorca, and Duydoy Bandigan, a local rider who comes from Mati and is being trained by the man himself, Mr. Benji Ecleo, here in San Jose, Dinagat, in the one of the extreme motocross racetrack in the country. Something is wrong with Duydoy Bandigan's motocross bike because he is slowing down. So I think there's something wrong with his bike, but battling for first place position is between Jan Flores, Wilson Pamorca of Iloilo, and Scott Raymon from Dumaguete City. So this is three rider battle for first place position here in the fourth leg of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series. So, okay, this is the motocross racetrack. So there's something wrong with Duydoy Bandigan's bike. And I think what he did was he parked, had his bike fixed with his mechanics, and he's back on racing. But right now he is already overlapped. He is already lapped by these three guys: Jan Flores, Wilson Pamorca, and Scott Raymon. All these guys come from different part of the country, Visayas mostly. But the pride and glory for who will be the first place winner here in the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit is, by chance, we will see when the checkered flag is up. But right now, they are still battling for first place position. Janjan Flores, Wilson Pamorca, and Scott Raymon is, you know, battling each other bar to bar until the checkered flag. So this is motocross racing at its best, only here at CCTN. So we will be having a replay of this program every Sunday night at 10 p.m. and the regular time is Saturdays 10 a.m. for you guys to watch. Next week we will show you the second episode still of the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross series, and right now this is the first heat for the intermediate class. And Janjan Ablawan, Janjan Flores is already being overtaken by Win Supermorca, and I think Scott Bremen is relaxing and viewing these guys battling first place position here in a very dusty 3.5 kilometer motocross racetrack, and one of the extreme motocross racetrack in the country right now. And I'm safe to say that this is the Glen Helen of motocross raceway here in the Philippines. So whenever you want to experience motocross racing, come over to Dinagat Island, because the racetrack is open for the public riders to come and ride and experience motocross racing. So everybody's invited to run and ride here in the San Jose Raceway of Benji Eclio. So right now it's Janjan Flores against Scott Remen and Wilson Pamorca for the first heat of the intermediate class. And I think the white flag is up. One more lap to go for Scott Remen, and he is now leading the pack, followed by John Flores and Windsor Pamorca for the intermediate class. Doidoy Bandigan is back to racing with his fixed motorcycle, but Scott Remen is still having, or is still giving 100%, or even though it's one lap to go. So the checkered flag is up for the intermediate class for Scott Remen. First, second goes to John Flores, third Windsor Pamorca, and fourth goes to Doidoy Bandigan.
So congratulations to Remy Scott for winning the fourth MS MotoSuit race. Hey, congratulations, how do you feel right now?
I feel very stoked and very hot right now.
That's so cool. At the same time, what advices can you give to our fellow aspiring racers?
Keep on training, don't give up, believe in yourself, fight, even if it's hot or raining, just keep on fighting.
So, what is really your secret in winning?
I don't know, I just want to ride good, safe, consistent, and keep my mind in focus all the time. That's it.
Okay, so right now, to become, now that you're a champion already, what are your future plans?
To keep training motocross and hopefully to get better in the sport and go up to pro rank someday.
Who is your inspiration in joining this kind of game?
My inspiration is mostly pro riders, my friends, Donar Gusan, Warnock, Glenn Aguilar, all of them, all of the pros, they're awesome. They just want to make me push harder.
Alright, thank you and congratulations, Scott. You're the man.
Since 1989, MS MotoSuit seat cover is a byword among motocross enthusiasts. The original manufacturer in the country today of quality MotoSuit seat cover. As the years gone by, MS MotoSuit seat covers has retained its quality and its durability. MS MotoSuit seat cover. It is safe for motorcycle lovers because of its grip seat that can hold a rider whether in a motocross competition or in an ordinary ride. MS MotoSuit seat covers is also designed in all kinds of weather condition. MS MotoSuit seat covers, the design for your bike, suit for your life.
MS, MS MotoSuit, suit for your life, design for your bike. MS, MS MotoSuit.
Okay, welcome back, and that was the first heat for the intermediate class, and this is now the first heat for the executive A-class. Eight riders are here right now. Atoy Bilikan, Russell Gonob, Rodel Bustamante, Danden Katipay, Jason Bayawa, Rolando Celia, Pepo Ruby, and Jordan Bandigan is here for the first round, or for the first heat of the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series here in the 3.5 kilometer motocross racetrack. So these guys is scheduled for three laps for motocross racing. So this is the first heat for the executive A class, and leading the pack is number 888 or 888, Rodel Bustamante from Compostela Valley, Davao. I think that's Oriental or Del Sur, Compostela Valley. But anyway, that is a part of Davao, and this is motocross racing, and this is one of the top guys in the executive class who is, or who are, these are the riders battling for pride and glory in the executive class. So this is motocross racing at its best here in the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series in the 3.5 kilometer extreme motocross racetrack. In this racetrack, you ask it, we have it. We have berms. This is an aerial shot of a berm, double jump, triple jumps, uphills, downhills. The lowest gear for this racetrack is a third gear for a 450, and most of the gears in your bike will be used until the fifth gear, especially in this area from the finish line to the first turn. It's fifth gear all the way for the number 888 motorcycle by Rodel Bustamante, who is leading the pack. And most of the riders who are first timers in this racetrack always ask who built the racetrack. So this racetrack is built by Benji Eclio. We will try to have an interview with Benji Eclio in one of the episodes. So this is the first episode of the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series here in Dinagat, San Jose, Dinagat Island. So we have this part of the racetrack. It's third gear all the way, triple jumps. So it's about five or six single jumps on a straightaway. So the checkered flag is up for the executive A class. Official winners for the first heat, 888, Rodel Bustamante, number 5, Pepo Ruby, number 9, Rolando Celia, Dandin Katipay, and 5th goes to Jason Bayawa.
MS MotoSuit Motocross Series would like to thank the following: ASC Prime Trade Incorporated, Leo Vins, SSS Rocket, Excel Asia, Quick Flight Racing,
just witnessed the first episode of the fourth round of the MS MotoSuit Motocross Series here in San Jose, Dinagat. Next week, we'll show you more of the thrills and spills of motocross racing, because as the saying goes in motocross, no excuses, because racing is everything. I'm your host, Pepo Ruby of Quick Flight Racing. See you next week.
MS
MotoSuit Motocross TV.